All right, we are recording. We are live. And I want to thank everyone for showing up. This is the Family Tree. How's everybody feeling? All right, everybody good?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, all right, all right.
Everything's all good.
In spite of it all, you're doing well. You're moving forward in the world, going backwards. How about that?
Isn't it the truth?
I want to say welcome. If this is the first time you're calling or dialing in, we want to say welcome. But also, this is the Family Tree, and we look at this as the real source for all that you got going on in your life. You know, they say when you want something done in your family, you go to the Family Tree, right?
That's right. That's right.
That means this is your Social Security. We actually talk about the holistic health and the things that are going on in the world. But also, if you have a question or concern, look right down to your reactions on your panel, and you can click on and raise your hand, and we'll try to get to a question to answer for you. If we don't know, we'll find out the answer for you, okay? Mm-hmm. And if you are someone that's calling from a phone line or you're dialing in, this make us aware that you're there, and we will try to get to you, okay?
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
All right. And if you have a chat, if you want to chat, you can chat your question in also. If you want to chat, just make sure you let Big B over there, who is my co-host with the mo-host right there. Just give Big B a hand. Let's give him a hand. Hey. All right, let's give Bill a hand.
I've been exercising my hands too, boy. What are you talking about?
And I want to say we're going to turn it over to you, Big B, and tell us what's going on, man, in the world.
Man, the world is crazy. But I'm telling you, look. The tree has got it going on because we the only ones that got the best health plan in the world. You know what
that's
I mean?
Right. That's
the
right.
The best
that's
health
right.
plan in the world is yourself. Help me now.
That's right.
All right. Listen, guys, as we always know, we take our first information from our favorite website that is encode2019.live, so you can keep up all the numbers that nobody tells you about. We have all the other things, right? We come up right quick. We call our quick facts as about 17 minutes ago. Our total confirmed cases, Dr. Paul, right now, as we're looking at it, 175,141,802. That's the total current confirmed cases around the world. Total critical cases, 85,306. Okay, 85,306. Total deceased, 3,775,643. All right, now. Total active cases, 17,655,234. Those are the totally active cases. Here we go. Give me my drum roll, doctor. Give me my drum roll. Here we go. Total recovered cases, guys. Mental health time, 151,220,830. Now that's what's up. That's what's up, family.
That's recovered.
See, that's recovered. That's recovered, everybody.
That's recovered. Yes, see? Yes.
Stuff like that nobody tells you about.
That's right. And we celebrate on the Family Tree. We talk about how it is to be celebrated if you've gone through and you've been diagnosed with NCOV and you've gone through it and you've come out of it and now you're better. What were you doing? I think,
yes,
don't you
yes.
think that we need to start to backtrack now to see of all those 100 and what was it, 157 million people?
Yes, sir. 157 million.
Of those 157 people, what were they doing to do to keep themselves healthy or get mm-hmm. through what they mm-hmm. went through? So we want to talk about all those things today. So I want to go in. I want to talk about some of the hot things that are on the list. Yes, we are still in the pandemic. Yes, you know, we've been talking about here on the Family Tree for about the last 3 weeks mm-hmm. about the latest move on what's happening in the world over in India. You mm-hmm. got to keep your eyes on India, family. They have what's now called the Delta. You know, I've been talking about the Delta for about 3 weeks now. Delta is the latest of the strains of the variants that are taking place, and it's happening right in United States now. It's coming through. It's actually in places. Here, the Delta is actually in the UK right now, and they're talking about shutting down. Their option date, I believe it was, Big B, we talked about it on Sunday, June the 21st, I believe,
that's
is their
correct.
Freedom Day.
Mm-hmm.
Their Freedom Day. They're trying to let themselves open up totally, but now I think they're going to put it on pause now because of this thing called Delta. Today was the first day that we really got, if you look at the streamlined headlines, they're talking about the Delta today. Did anyone see that about the Delta? Anyone see it?
No, I didn't.
Yeah. Yeah, they're actually starting to put out that the Delta, it's actually probably 40 to 50 times more contagious. Wow. They know that it spreads a lot faster. And also some of the effects that they know that a lot of the Medicaid, the ones that they even said, the vaccines, they're coming up and saying that, well, we don't think that they will cover this new variant. So what does it mean? We mean we have to go back to plan A, y'all, back to plan A, which is doing and building your immune system. You know, we talked about from the very beginning, what are you doing to build your immune system? Are you still going back to that list? We can go back to that list today. Talk about some of those things. You remember? Y'all remember this one right here? I don't know if y'all remember that one. Old Indian wild cherry bark syrup.
Yes,
y'all remember that one?
Yes, sir.
That's not a bad one to grab right now. Yeah. Because not only is that new variant coming through, but the new variant is coming through, but there's another thing called black fungus. Mm-hmm. Black fungus is also coming through. Black fungus and white fungus. So with that, what does it mean? Attack on the lungs, attack on the blood. So you got to keep the blood clean. So things like the Old Indian, maybe I'll go into that today to tell you what's in that and the history of the Old Indian wild cherry bark syrup. That's what that is. Old Indian wild cherry bark syrup. It's a formula that's about 250 years old. How about that?
Okay.
Yes, it's an old formula. So we're going to go into the questions today. And remember, if you have a question, just raise your hand. I'm just going to go potluck today, Big B. How about that?
That sounds good, man.
Okay. Good. And let's see.
If there, anyone has any questions, they'll put them into the chat. And if I see them, we'll get them up there. Make sure that Dr. Paul gets to them. Okay.
Okay. Got it. All right, so the first person I have up here, is that Ashioma?
Yes, please.
Ashioma, how you doing today?
Not too bad. How you doing?
Good, good. Everything is well.
Good, 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 good. Thank you so much for everything, Dr. Paul.
Thank
and brother
you.
Gil. I have been having chest pain. I've had more than 6 episodes of chest pain. Mm-hmm. I know I'm on prednisone. Because the doctor did say it was heartburn, I guess acid reflux, but it's mm-hmm. just becoming increasingly painful and it's been consistent, like ongoing.
Mm-hmm.
I've had like 6 or 7 episodes in the last month.
Now, when you say 6 or 7 episodes of what? Just chest pain?
Chest pain.
Tightness in the chest?
Tightness.
Right. Yes. Have you been ever diagnosed with asthma of any time?
No. Okay. I don't have difficulty in breathing. Mm-hmm. It's just so tight and painful.
Okay. What about your back? Any back problems?
Oh, yeah. I've had mm-hmm. chronic pains going for the longest time.
Yeah, watch the back pains. Usually the back pains, which causes chest pain sometimes, if you don't have shortness of breath. That's why we're looking at things like the breathing. As long as your breathing is going well, and that's, you know, that we think that the lungs are clear. Any mucus or anything like that? Any mucus at all? Right.
No.
So it sounds like a structural issue. See, you have that T2, thoracic 2, mm-hmm. thoracic 2. Write that down. Thoracic 2. T2, T5. That's right where the area where you can get sometimes chest pains. I would get a structural assessment from a chiropractor to see if that may be causing a problem, especially if you have a history of back pains. Got it? Because when you talk about that area right where the chest is, mm-hmm. you remember I showed y'all the sublation chart? Y'all remember the sublation chart, right?
Mm-hmm.
The chart will show you that causes chest conditions, and in some cases, it feels like tightness in the chest. So remember, vertebrae sits like this, disc in the middle, nerves spin off the disc. If there's any contraction, which is bone touching nerve, cuts the signal, oxygen, and nutrients to that area, which is the organs. So very much watch the T2. Specifically, I want to focus on that T2. Got it? See Big B holding that up over there? Right there where you see T2. You see T2? All right.
No, we can't see that.
Okay. You can't see that, Big B.
You guys as blind as I am? That's all right.
Well, let me see if I can bring that up.
Share. See if you can bring it up and share it, Dr. Paul.
Okay, got it.
I knew everybody's eyes was better than mine. Here they go. Boy, y'all better stop.
All right. So we're going to bring that up and I'll show you. And, you know, do you have a chiropractor, by the way?
Yes.
Okay. Are you going there regularly?
Not regularly.
Okay. Yeah. You want to make sure that you make the adjustments. But you know what you can do to help that? If you have that chest pain again, just lay flat on your back. Lay flat on your back, okay? So remember, with the back of your palms, back of your hand, right? Laying flat with your hands extended, like that. Lay flat on the floor, not on a flat floor. It has to be a flat floor, okay?
Okay.
And let me see if I can pull this up real quick. I'll show you all. And just this is a reboot for some of those that have seen this before. T2 is actually, and I'll share this with you. And we'll share that.
Where's that?
Auntie Juliet's is here.
Okay, I'm coming.
There we go.
Okay, you see that? Okay, if you can see right here, T2, right here. See where the T2 is?
Yes.
It's along in the center of the back, right in the area close to the heart. So the heart, including its valves and covering coronary arteries, functional heart conditions, and certain chest conditions. Got it? There you go, right there. All right? So that's where you want to watch. Those areas, T2, T3, T1 through T3 is what I would check out. Okay? Those are areas that deal with congestion, but also chest conditions, because it can be tightness, things like that. All right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, family? So this is also the cervical. You know, the cervical is C1 through C7. And also going through the middle of the back, which is T1 through T12. And then, of course, the lower lumbar, L1 through L5. Got it? Now, when you've corrected and made sure that you're structurally sound, then you can go back and see if there's some other issues. If you're structurally correct and then, you know, the chiropractor says you're in good shape and you still have areas like that, then we know that's something that you're eating. Got it? It's something you're eating. And we got to look at your food choices. We got to look at the food choices to say, what are you eating? Can you be getting possibly something, you know, that's causing a lot of inflammation of some sort? Okay.
Okay.
All right, family. All right.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Where did my screen go? I lost my screen. All right, Big B, you got any questions over there?
Yeah, Dr. Ball is one over here that says, what do you do for fibroids? Also, how do you fight bronchitis and asthma developed from COVID?
Okay, say that one more time for me.
Okay. Mm-hmm. First of all, what do you do for fibroids? That's number one.
Fibroids,
Number two is, how do you fight bronchitis and asthma developed from COVID?
Okay, definitely fibroids is, we shrink fibroids. We don't rip, burn, or cut anything out. That's the key. And that's usually where people fall short. They start to, you know, people start to go in, you know, immediately. You know, the J&J, you know, we talk about the J&J shot, right? Mm-hmm. You know, the J&J shot we talk about. But a lot of people don't remember that J&J had another thing that was, that a lot of women had problems with. And that was called the morcellator. Anybody know what the morcellator was? The morcellator? Anyone ever heard of that?
The morcellator?
That was actually a device that was used for pulling out or literally grinding up fibroid cysts and tumors. Wow. How about that? And it was a device that looked like a blender. That's what it looked like.
Oh, I remember that. Yes.
You remember that?
Yes, I remember.
They actually recalled that.
Yes.
They recalled that. They had to recall it because of the fact that it was causing so many problems. So it was like a blender effect. So when people or women had the issues with fibroid cysts and tumors, they would try to determine that it was benign. And then they would go in and then they would just literally like a blade, this chop it up.
Mm-hmm.
Very reckless. It's amazing. And then from that, they would take this device and then, you know, of course, you know, suck all of that stuff out of there. But then they found out that women that were doing this probably 6 to 9 months afterwards, they were coming back with expanded levels of cancer that they said it just spread and they couldn't figure it out. They found out it was the morcellator because what it was that the cancer never went anywhere. It just spread it all around into the uterus, into areas like that. So that was another recall, along with another recall, which was, of course, the, you know, the powders. You know the powders?
Yes.
The, you know, the, what was it? The talcum powder.
The talcum powder.
Yep. Everybody knows that talcum powder. That's, you know, that's dirt. That literally is dirt. That's what powder really is. It's dirt. Man, that's amazing. That's amazing, amazing, amazing that we are still dealing with this. So, yes, J&J did some incredible things, and now we got a shot that had to be recalled now. Now they're talking about their expiring on their vaccines. Yo, family, watch J&J. Just back up off of them. What was the other question, Big B?
That one was about the bronchitis and asthma developed from COVID.
Yeah, yeah. The bronchitis and, you know, issues with breathing after COVID, right? Is that what you're saying? After?
Yes, I got it.
Right. That's when you have to start to do the main things like we talk about. You have to go back to the old Indian wild cherry bark syrups, the elderberry syrups, okay? Not to diagnose, treat, cure, prevent any disease, just food for the soul, family. Here's my elderberry. Can y'all see that?
Yeah, I can cool over bottle. Here.
Cool bottle, I mean. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. It's a cool bottle. That's the old school bottle right there. That's the John with the old syrup, John, you know. Yep. This is by I got this over at Wayne Avenue Health Food Store. And it's a sister over there that is actually doing this. And she's got some great stuff. So I would say go on over there. This is a combination of elderberry, but it also has alkaline water, bladder rack, sea moss, organic elderberries, of course, clove root, ginger root, cinnamon, and buckwheat honey.
Okay.
That's what's in here. Right. This is a nice combination right here. Yeah. Can y'all see that?
Yep, right there. I can. It's not very readable, but you can see it.
Yeah, you can see it, though.
Yep, that you can see. There you go.
That. Mm-hmm. That better. Yep. A little better. Just ask for that. That's at Wayne Avenue Health Food Store. Got it? And you can get that. And that's what we use for bronchitis and issues with asthma and things like that with breathing. You have to open up the bronchial tubes again. You know, a lot of people are having breathing problems, yes, because you're inhaling a lot of the fumes, a lot of the dust, the mold, the things that are going on. We've been in the house a lot, you know, for the last year and a half almost, people have been in the house. So that means also you got to clean out the house, you know, dust out the rugs, start to sweep up. You know, did you know that because of the COVID-19, you know, there's a plague of mice in Australia. Did y'all hear about this? The plague of mice in Australia. Are y'all reading y'all stuff? Are y'all reading?
No. No.
Y'all looking at me like, what? Another plague? Yes, another plague. And it's the mice.
On the news.
Yes, yes.
It was on the news.
That's right. Wasn't it, Gwen? Did you see it?
Yeah, it was. Yeah. I saw it. Yes.
Yeah. What did you see?
Crazy. There were mice everywhere. They were flying and oh my God.
Wow.
Crazy.
There was mice everywhere, you know. And you know what the mice were doing? You know, they said that this is the first year ever that the mice actually got wise. And when people were staying in the house, when the mice usually go out, they usually end up dying in the fields, right? But this year, they stayed in the house with the people.
Wow.
I ain't going out there. COVID is out there, man. I'm staying right in here. So they stayed in. And by them staying in, they multiplied and multiplied to the point where they have a pandemic over there with mice right now.
Oh, my God. Don't let that come over here. Oh, Lord. Please.
Clean out. Well, this is the thing. Remember, they had a reason to stay because when people stay in the house more, you start to eat more.
Yes, indeed.
You got it? You're going to leave more crumbs around. You're going to eat open dishes open. You know, the mice was like, hey, why am I going outside? All the food is in here.
It's all inside here.
I ain't got to go nowhere. I'm staying right here. So that's exactly what happened. So they have a pandemic of mice right now that's going on right in. Uh-oh, somebody's out. Somebody's
make sure you get all muted up, guys.
Yeah.
Come on, real quick.
So issues with breathing. So the point I was making with breathing. Mm-hmm. You got to clear the lungs out. You got to get out there at least once a day. If you're not going out, you don't have anywhere to go, at least go outside to get some air to open up the lungs. You know, start the breathing. Remember, breathe in. What? Breathe in. Stomach comes out. Belly mm-hmm. breathe. Got it? Mm-hmm. Blow mm-hmm. it out. You got to get that carbon dioxide out. You need to do that at least once or twice a day, you know, so that you can continue to keep your lungs clean. You know, if you're sitting in the house, you know, a lot of dust builds up. Mm-hmm. Even when you have the fans and things rolling in the house, you know, and then also the filters that are happening with the air conditioning, you're going to have to keep that stuff clean. Got it? So get outside, open up the door. Sometimes you want to open up the door too. Open up the back door, let the air, get fresh air in.
That's what I was about to ask about circulation in the house.
Circulation in the house, fresh
yes.
air.
Yes,
fresh so air. So that along with taking the specific herbs and, you know, I may can give you a list of some of the ones that I recommend, which are some of the ones that are, you know, we talked about very early in the COVID, when it was an epidemic before it became a pandemic. So maybe I can go over those today, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, let's see. Who do we have next? Who do we have next? Let's see here. Is that Cheryl T?
Yes, thank you.
Cheryl, turn that down a little bit.
Okay.
Can you turn it down a little bit?
How about now?
Yeah, way down. Keep going, keep going.
All right. Tell me when.
Keep going.
Yeah, keep going, keep going, keep going.
Now?
Yeah, keep going. That might be it may be.
I'll be meeting in a minute.
It may be your headphone.
Yeah.
It may be your headphone. Your headphones may be turned up. Can you turn your headphones down?
Okay. Better.
A little better. Go ahead. Keep talking.
Okay.
Maybe I'll just unplug it. No, how about now? Can you hear me now?
That's a little better.
That's a lot better.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
That's all right.
I had two concerns. You know, when you go out in Fairmount Park, you see a lot of dandelion roots. I'm requesting maybe you can get the guy who does the tours in Fairmount Park to come in as a guest one Wednesday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're talking about. Sure. Yeah, we talk
and
about
the second.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And how do you use the old Indian cherry bark? How often should you take that?
You can take it as often as you need it. It's a syrup and it is for, and remember, it's food. Got it? So with this syrup, if you are someone, let me just give you the most extreme situation. If you have an extreme situation where you have a cold or you know that you have something, we usually take it every hour on the hour for the first 4 hours. This is if you have a full-blown cold or you think you got a flu or something like that. Got it? You would take it every hour on the hour for the first 4 hours, and then after that, every 2 hours until you feel better. Got it? Usually that's
okay.
That usually starts to build the immune system back. Some of the herbs that are in there would be yerba, Y-E-R-B-A. There's L campaign. There's also the black cherry bark, of course. One of my favorites, and this is whorehound. You remember the whorehound cough drops? You remember that? Okay, y'all need to remember all this stuff, y'all. Hyssop. You know, we talk about hyssop. May I purge my body with hyssop, right? Also, marshmallow is in here. Apricot seeds are good. Those are good for bronchial also. These are good things. You know, apricot seeds were very instrumental in folks who had cancer. They were taking apricot seeds, which were used for, you know, they're like cancer scavengers. It goes after cancer.
Yes.
All right. Last one I would say would be licorice root and stinging nettle. So it's got a lot of good stuff in here. That with a lot of other ones. So you would just take it every hour on the hour. If you just want general health, you can just take it once or twice a day.
Okay.
Tablespoon. And okay.
Is there an herb for a sugar addiction?
Mm-hmm. Yep. That's the one we talk about, the Gemnema. We had a whole special on gymnema, G-Y-M-N-E-M-A, and it has what's called gymnemic acid. Gymnemic acid takes the desires from you to want the cravings to actually want it. Okay.
So and that's the same. How often would you take that?
Well, you can take that as often as needed. Just take it as directed to start, as it says on the bottle. You can always do a tea. Usually, if you're starting with a tea, you can start it off twice a day, first thing in the morning, just before you go to bed at night. That's what you usually do. Or before, like, your last meal, I'm sorry. Like, usually around 7 o'clock. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Good stuff. Good questions. All right, Big B, you got anybody on the chat there?
Oh, yeah.
Have a question?
Yeah. Uh-huh. There was one that was talking about how do you... let me go back up here. In regard to recommendation for an allopathic doctor that is integrative. In other words, I guess that can give you some That's suggestions fine. From both sides.
Mm-hmm. Does that count, Kamara, that you said that?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, that's actually a good question. There are integrated doctors. I work with integrated doctors also. Thomas Jefferson has integrative doctors. But their goal is to do natural until they absolutely have to do, pharmaceutical. That's what they're mm-hmm. supposed to do. That's what all pharmacists are supposed to do.
Yes.
When the pharmacists... there is a level that they study poison. Pharmacists study poison. Mm-hmm. So the whole concept is that we will give the body food, which is the nutrients, until we have to now start to give it poison. Got it? So yes, there are integrative doctors. I tend to notice that a lot of the integrated doctors are they usually were moving towards pharmaceuticals. That's why when we started to work with them, a lot of them moved towards the pharmaceuticals. And we were kind of wondering, why are you, don't abandon the naturopathic concept that the body can heal itself by you feeding the body and it corrects itself. So, yeah, they are out there. You just, Thomas Jefferson.
You just have to ask.
You got to ask, yeah. They have a whole... department over at Jefferson down at about 9th and I think it was 9th and Market, down about 9th and Market Street. Mm-hmm. Oh, got it? And okay. I did do research. I used to do research with Jefferson. So we did, I used to do what's called the Holistic Health Program, where we did a pre and post evaluation. It was called an evidence-based program with Jefferson. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So I did two research projects with them. Right. So I met a lot of the integrated doctors down there. They're real good too. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
All right.
What about anxiety and depression, Doc?
What about anxiety and depression?
What do you prescribe for someone diagnosed with anxiety and depression?
A vacation.
I'll go with you.
A vacation. You got to know how to relax, y'all. You know what? I believe a lot of stress that we carry has everything to do with just worry. Worry on the mind does so much to people. You can't do nothing about it, but yet we tend to let it just stick on our mind. Sometimes it's what somebody said to you. It's like somebody says something. You say, why they say that? And then it's bug you all night, Don't lose sleep over it.
We beat our own selves up.
Don't lose sleep over it. Got it? Because it's something that tends to cause a lot of issues with you moving forward. Just try to keep a peace of mind about what's going on with yourself. Mm-hmm. And I say, have a list of goals for every day. Every day, have something that I'm going to achieve today. Something that I'm going to start to do. If there's an ultimate goal, let there be short-term goals, and then there are long-term goals. This is the perfect time to follow your dreams, follow the things that you want to do in life. You might have said, they always told me I could write. So Big B, I'm going to write that book. I'm going to write that book. Mm-hmm. I'm going to write that book. I got time to do it. Go ahead and do it.
Yeah.
Start that business. You got that business. Boy, you the baddest knitter I ever seen. You can knit together something, boy. Let me tell you, start that business. You might go big boom on the internet. You never know. So whatever you do, take that gift and now nurture that gift and now bring it to the world.
And that's be open to what the master shares with you first thing.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Always be open. I'm going to tell you.
And remember what he has for you, he has for you.
Yeah, that's right. And for you and not me. You know, we are on two different tracks. And you've got to be open and honest about these kinds of things, folks. Stop beating yourselves up. You know, you've got so many of us right now, Dr. Paul, have great gifts, but we are afraid because what we heard somebody say about us. Guess what? They don't know you.
That's right.
Only dad knows you because he created you. And he says, I'm asking you and I'm going to challenge you to trust me. So put one foot forward and run to daylight.
Right. And we have to stop waiting for someone to give us permission to move forward in your dream. You got it? Stop waiting for permission for somebody to give you, you know, to move forward in your dream. God gave it to you. Now, don't expect everybody else to see it. You know what? So many dreams will die in conversations with people.
Isn't it the truth?
Wow.
Isn't that the
in
truth?
In conversations with people. You get into a conversation and you think it's good, and then they talk you right out of your own dream.
I know that's right.
Don't let that happen. Don't let nobody talk you out of your own dream. You know, that's where, you know, your dream is what God has given to you. That's why you see it the best, because it was for you, not for somebody else. So that means you have to bring this to the world, whatever it is.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Be encouraged, family. Be encouraged. All right.
Can I piggyback off of that for a minute?
Only if you veggie back. That's what we don't piggyback over here.
Right, veggie back. I'm veggie back.
You a veggie backer. Okay.
You better believe it. You better believe it. I want to say hello to everyone. This is Diane.
Yes, all right, Diane. How are you?
I'm good. I just wanted to say that we as human beings and have been taught either generationally or through just living to be looking for other people to validate us.
That's right.
And we cannot look for validation through other people. We have to be willing to understand that we are worthy. We have to feel worthy within ourselves so that we don't need the validation from others, that's and that we look to God for everything that we need. And that's easier said than done. But it needs to be something that starts with the process and the mind first, and feeling good about yourself and knowing that you are all that. And
I know that's right.
And you, yes, absolutely. And thank you so much. And that you have a special talent.
Yes.
You know, we all have something that's unique about us that we can do that nobody else can do. Like,
amen.
We do.
So
how about that? So ain't that awesome?
True.
That's boy, I tell you, that's some serious gifts right there. So you got to find out your gift. That was the whole concept back in the ancient times, that when the child was born, the job of the tribe or the job of the people was to bring out or discover the gift in the child, which was the true gift or dream that helps the tribe to move on to the next generation.
Yes.
So
the
child was the blessing. That was the blessing, that the child would bring forth a gift that would bless everybody. So that's why they came with the concept of it takes a village to raise a child.
Yes.
Came from concept. So, you know, find your gift, y'all. This is your time. You sitting home, you ain't doing nothing. Go ahead. Find your gift.
Well.
I think I got some singers in here.
Well, y'all, let's just have a home session.
I think I got some singers in here. We got some hummers in here.
Well, you never know.
All right.
I see Queen Flo with her hand up in the air with her Dr. P.
I see you. I see you, Flo. All right. Go ahead, Flo. I see you.
I just have two questions. What can you do for sciatic?
Sciatic nerve?
Yeah, I've been doing the stretches up against the wall and trying to touch my toes, but they have steroids, but that pain is still there.
Yeah, see, the sciatic nerve spins off the lower lumbar. You remember that lower lumbar, specifically around the L4. Is that around the time, around the L4? So what's happened is pressing on there. And then what happens is off the spine, spins down, goes through the hip bone, down by the back of the leg. That's where the pain starts to happen. That inflammation is happening there. So what you have to do, you got to take the pressure off of that area. Remember, I would suggest, are you putting a little weight on, you know, things like squats? You ever do squats?
Yeah.
Are you doing squats right now?
No.
I mean, don't have to be full squats. Just small squats like this. Squats. Slightly, okay. Not enough to be too much pressure on your knees. Okay. But you have to start to strengthen the back. Usually sciatic issues are coming from, number one, there's a pinched nerve there. But number two, a weak back. So you got to strengthen that back again. Starting to do things like the squats. Just mini squats. See how I'm squatting like this? Just yeah. Like this. Start like this. And then every day you go down a little farther. You go down a little farther. Almost like if you would have something like a bar, imaginary bar, on your back. Got it?
Well, you know, when I do squats, I use the ball. I put the ball behind my back and up mm-hmm. the wall. Mm-hmm. And I go like that.
Mm-mm. Don't cheat. You cheating. You're cheating. Don't cheat. Just basically don't put the ball back there. You need to get that. You spread your legs and you stick your butt out. That's what you do. You know, a proper squat is when you basically just squat just a little bit. So you got to get you have to get that nerve, that bone off that nerve. So the muscle is what's going to build that to strengthen, to hold that. Are you side sleeping still? Are you side sleeping?
But I bought one of those lumbar pullers to put between my legs.
Right. And you have a chiropractor, right? You going to?
No, I have a spine doctor.
Okay, but a chiropractor is more in line with what you're doing. So definitely a chiropractor. You got to get that aligned. Sometimes, you know, I went on for about a year not knowing that I had a lower lumbar issue. It was the most painful thing that I have ever experienced. And it wasn't until I went to the gym and I did a squat and it went just like that.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I had put, when, as soon as I put yes. weight on it, I put weight on it, it corrected itself. So, so just a little bit of squats without weights. First off, start going like that. Just a little squats, not enough to put pressure on the knees, but you got to build the back. Got it? Okay. Lower back. There are some lower lumbar exercises. Let me see. I'll see if I can find a couple for you before we leave, okay?
Okay, because I looked on your website, but I didn't see any.
Yeah, none on there on that. Just the sublation chart is on there. So let me see if I can find something. But you get the concept, though, right? Get the concept? Yeah. Okay, lower lumbar, you know. Exercise. Yeah, okay. You got to get maybe I might be able to find a video. Let me see if I can find a video for y'all. Oh, here's one right here. I think I found a video for y'all. Hold on. Let me see if I can find this one here. And this is good stuff. This is good stuff. All right, you ready? Let me switch up. Y'all want me to switch up? Let me see if I can do that.
There you go.
All right, let me see.
And by the way, if there's audio on it, make sure you check that one spot to make sure we hear the audio too, Dr. P.
Yep. Optimize for video clip also?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
And if you can give us the website so I can go back.
Right. Here it is right here. Let me know when you're there. Can you see
it? Yep, it's there. Mm-hmm, it's there.
Got it? See it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hey everybody, it's Dr. Joe and Lion Callie. Arr! And today I'm going to show you my top 5 ways to relieve lumbar stenosis. So let's get started. Arr! Disclaimer alert.
You got to say that disclaimer.
So the first thing we're going to do is a simple knee to chest stretch. So just go ahead and lie down on your back. I like propping my knees up. That just takes some pressure off of your back, and especially if you have that lumbar stenosis, you want to bring them up just to relax that back a little bit. You don't have to. Sometimes people like to keep one leg down and bring the other one up, but I like to keep them bent. Another big thing is sometimes people grab up here for that knee to chest. If you have any knee issues, you might want to grab underneath. I just prefer that because that's sometimes putting a lot of pressure on your knee joint. So if you don't have any problems with your knees, that's fine, but I like to grab underneath. Once you grab underneath, just bring that knee up towards your chest as far as you comfortably can. Sometimes people have a little pain in the groin area. So if you have some pain while doing that, just don't pull up quite as hard. Just go to comfort level. You should feel a nice gentle stretch in your low back with this. And this just kind of helps open up those spaces and takes the pressure off of those nerves coming out of the canals of the spine. So you want to hold this for about 30 seconds. And I would definitely do both sides. So switching is the best for me. If you want to do them all on one side and then switch, you can, but I like alternating back and forth so one has a little bit of a break. So 30 seconds, three times on each side. So the next one is going to be a glute stretch. A lot of times with that lumbar stenosis, if you have tight glutes, that puts a lot of pressure on the spine. And again, if there's pressure there, that makes those little canals where the openings with those nerves going through smaller, and then it presses on those nerves, and that's what causes a lot of the pain. So a simple glute stretch, the easiest one is probably just doing the figure four stretch. If you have a hard time doing it this way, you can do it seated in a chair. But the side that you want to stretch, you're going to cross it over the other, just the top of the knee right there. And so it looks like a figure four if you're looking down. That's why it's called the figure four stretch. So you can do this a couple different ways. You want to really try and keep your back straight if you can. Some people kind of curl up like this, but if you're curling your back, you're not really getting a stretch. And if you have stenosis, even though the bending sometimes gives it relief, you don't want to do an extreme bending motion. So you can either keep your back straight and lean forward like that to get a stretch, and I'm feeling a nice stretch right through there, or you can stay in one spot keeping that back straight and then slide your heel up this way, and that will give you a big stretch as well. So this is another one where it's 30 seconds. I would do them on each side just like we talked about, so switching in between and doing 30 seconds on each side. So either, again, you can lean forward with your back straight, or you can slide that heel up to get that stretch. And again, that stretch should be comfortable. It shouldn't be painful, just some tension and some pressure.
Flo, you seeing this?
Yeah.
So then the next one's gonna be kind of a combination move. We're just gonna start off with a pelvic tilt, but we're gonna take it all the way into a dead bug exercise. But the pelvic tilt is how you start. So you really wanna master the pelvic tilt first. And all that is basically, it's like it sounds. You wanna take your pelvis and tilt it. So when I'm doing a pelvic tilt, this little curve in my back, I want to flatten it out towards the floor or the bed or the couch. You don't have to get down on the floor. If you're having a lot of pain and it's hard for you to get up off the floor, you can do this on your bed or on the couch. But the firmer, the better. When you're doing that pelvic tilt, you want to use your core and your pelvic muscles to do this. You don't want to use your legs. So if you're kind of bringing your bottom up like this, I'm pushing with my glutes and my hamstrings. That's not what you want. To help with that lumbar stenosis, to help the strengthening of the core, you want to use your core muscles to flatten it out. A lot of times I'll tell my patients, it's like you're fake laughing. Like if you're going, ha, 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 your core tightens up, and that's what you want. You want to feel those muscles contracting. So just holding it for about 3 to 5 seconds and then relaxing. Once you have that pelvic tilt down and you feel like you're doing a good job not using your legs anymore, then you're going to go into the dead bug. And the reason that you don't want to use your legs to hold that tilt is because now you're going to add some components and while you're holding that tilt. So I'm going to get myself into that pelvic tilt, and then I'm going to take one leg and just lift it up a little bit off the ground. I don't have to bring it all the way up. I'm just trying to keep that tilt the whole time I'm lifting the leg. And then when I lift the leg, I'm gonna take my opposite arm and bring it up. So I'm going up like this and then coming back down. So again, I'm not pulling my knee all the way up to my chest. I'm just kind of lifting it up, but I'm trying to keep that tilt the whole time. And if you do it right, it's a lot harder than it is. Like I can do, you know, this, but I'm not holding that tilt. So it's really all about holding that tilt and going slow. And then so just gently lifting up, lifting the arm up, getting that cross pattern in your body, and then slowly coming back down. And building up that core strength is really gonna help with that lumbar stenosis. So since this is kind of a combination move, it's a little hard to get figured out, I just do maybe 3 lifts on each side and then take a break. If you have to stop in between and reset the tilt, that's fine. So if I just did 1 and then come back down, I can stop and reset that tilt. But if you can hold it the whole time, that's even better. So then the next exercise is going to be going all the way up into a bridge. So again, we're going to be strengthening the glutes.
This is a tough one right here.
So we're still doing some strengthening. With bridging, you really want to now use those glutes to hamstrings and kind of drive your knees forward. As you're lifting up, you want to go one segment at a time of your back. You don't have to stop at each segment, but you don't want to just come up and down like this. You don't want to just use your momentum of your body to do it. You really want to come up one segment at a time, drive those knees forward, and then nice and slowly coming back down. So with the bridging, as long as it feels good, you just want to come to about level. You don't want to try and arch your back up. And then as long as it's not painful, you can just start off with maybe 10, two sets of 10, a couple times a day. So the last one is going to be getting up, and we're going to get onto all fours or in quadruped. So once you get into this position, again, if you can't get on the floor, you can do these on your bed. It might be a little squishy, so that might actually make you work a little bit harder because it'll be unstable, but you can definitely do these in the bed. So when you are in this quadruped position or on all fours, you want to try and keep your back, again, kind of straight, tighten up that core so you're not sagging down like this, you're not arching up. You know, it's a pretty straight line. It might not be exact, but you really want to keep that core nice and tight the whole time. So in this position, you're going to do what we call a bird dog. And so a bird dog is basically you're lifting one arm and kicking out the opposite leg. So it's kind of like the dead bug, but now you're having to do a little more stability of your whole body. So if you want to just start lifting out your arms, straightening them out, you can do that just to kind of practice a little bit. You can also then just kick your leg out, but the goal, especially when you're doing the leg kick, is not to lean over and kick like that. You want your back to stay flat that whole time. Like if I had a glass of water on my back, I'm trying not to make that glass of water fall. So once you have those two pretty much mastered, then you put it together where you're putting one arm out and the opposite leg out. And really just nice, try and control it. Again, imagine that you have that cup on your back, and if you're going fast, you're probably gonna spill it. So since this one's a little bit tougher, you definitely want to just start off with maybe two on each side, see how you feel, and then do that a couple times a day, and then you can progress from there. So those are my top five ways to relieve lumbar stenosis. If you'd like to help support my channel, make sure and click on the link up there, and don't forget to subscribe by clicking where? Down there. And remember, be safe, have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.
All right.
There you go. There you go, Phil.
Hey, everybody, it's Dr. Joe.
Okay, did you get that?
Lion Cat.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. So,
so how do we find this?
Okay, that's Dr. Joe. You can punch in top five lumbar spine exercises, and that's what I punched in. And then you can just put Google. Okay, lower lumbar exercise, and you can pull that up. That's Dr. Joe right there, Dr. Joe.
I'm going to definitely try that.
Yeah, see, there's so many things that you can do without weights. You don't have to do weights with everything. Yes. Everybody believes you got to do weights. You don't have to do weights with everything. You know, you can do something very simple like that, and it's right on the floor, and you don't have to do it, and you do it at your own pace. I see so many people with that lower back pain, you know, they're side sleepers, you remember? And then they wake up and they're feeling hard, you know, oh my goodness, my back is killing me from sleeping. Oh no, they're not supposed to be feeling that. So look at those exercises, look up Dr. Joe, she was one, but there's tons of them out there that you can do. And I didn't see the one that I was recommending, which was the squat, the slight squat. There is another doctor, his name is, you can punch in also best exercises to strengthen your lower back. If you punch that in under YouTube, you can usually find that, or you can go right to Google and do a search, okay? So it's the best exercises to strengthen your lower back. And you just go through all of them. Find the one that worked for you, right?
Yeah.
All right, Flo. Thank you. Good question.
Hey, wait a minute. I have another question. This is a quick one.
Okay.
The oil pulling. is it possible that the oil pulling, if your teeth are crooked, will they straighten it? Will that straighten it?
Yes, it will. Yes, it will. Yes, it will. There's people that have said that they've done the oil pulling and it starts to realign the gums. That is correct.
Yeah, it does. I thought I was seeing things. Okay.
Thank you. That means you start to, they start to straighten out because it tightens the gums. It also tightens the gums, but it also starts to align the teeth in the proper way. Gets rid of infections, kills staph and streptococcus bacteria on contact. It's amazing. You know, oil pulling goes back only 10,000 years. That they've been using it and it works and it makes the teeth white. That's the last thing. Makes your teeth white. Okay. All right. Good, good, good. All right, Flo. Thank you. Queen Flo. Thank you. Appreciate it. All right. We're going to go to, I have Helen. Helen?
How you doing, Dr. Paul? How are you, Bill?
Hey, Helen. How are you?
Doing well.
Great. I have a couple of things. I just wanted to show you the first thing that I have. I'm not sure if you can see it. That's the sunflower. The sunflower.
Sunflower oil?
Yeah.
Okay.
The unrefined.
Okay.
I don't know if I can show it to you or not.
If you move it right to the center of the screen, usually to the center of the screen. There you go. Right there.
There you are. Okay. Right there.
Mm-hmm. So I have the unrefined one, organic.
Yes.
That's the first one. Excellent. And then I've gotten that oil pull she was referring to, the Spectrum, the sesame seed unrefined also.
Excellent.
I did a little shopping. Yes, and I got my Icelandic water.
Okay, that's right. You got it. Yes. That's right.
And I also got one of these things from off of Amazon. You know, this big one here is like a half a gallon. That's all I need because you said half of the body weight.
Mm-hmm.
I got that as well. So also, I wanted to let you know that I'm going to be going in to have the mercury removed from the back of my teeth. Mm. And they're going to just do the little filling in. But they want to remove my two wisdom teeth. And I don't want them to do that because they're not bothering me. Why do they want to do that? You know,
That's right.
So they want to make money just to, you know, remove teeth, you know?
Yeah, that's right.
So yep. I'm not going to have them do that at all.
I understand, you know, if they don't, we say not broke, don't fix them. You don't have to be fixed, right? If there's enough room back there for them, you know, then you're okay. Now, if it was a problem, then you would go in there. If there's a structural issue where it was not, you know, the something was not fitting properly or they were growing in or causing pressure on another tooth or a nerve issue, then yes, there would have to be something done because that becomes a structural issue. The thing that they get into is that you know that those wisdom teeth, the upper and the lower, they control equilibrium and balance. They deal with equilibrium and balance. That means that when that's dealing with the inner and outer ear and equilibrium and balance, that's why when they pull them, they usually tell you, you know, you're going to need somebody to drive you home because you're going to be dizzy, you know, coming out of there. But nowadays, you really remember when you break the skin, you increase the chances for infection. You got it? So as long as they don't need to come out, I think you're spot on. I think you're spot on. But mercury, that's got to go.
Right.
Mercury's got to go. Yeah, mercury's got to go. You know, mercury is the biggest thing. It is a banned element. Now, are you going to a biological dentist or a specialist for that?
No, it's not a biologist specialist, but it is a, you know, good dentist that covers my plan, and they said they could do it, so I'm just going to
Okay, good, good. It's good that some dentists will do it because most of them won't. They'll all say, we're going to outsource you to a specialist that can pull that out. They don't even want to handle mercury anymore. So it's a good thing. So best wishes for you that everything works out for you on that. But guess what? After it's over, oil pull. There you go. Start the oil pull.
All right. And one last thing is concentration as far as the drinks. Like if I were to buy like blueberry juice or pineapple juice, what is the best to do, non-concentrate or concentrate?
If you can get non-concentrate, that would be the best. But if you do find concentrate, you want to put the water back in it. So if you're doing 12 ounces of a drink, right, you would just, if it was concentrated, you would do just 6 ounces, and then you add 6 ounces of water. So you're putting the water back into it. Got it? That's usually what we do, because concentrate is just a form of, you know, just preserving also, and that's too concentrated for most people. So just add the water, okay?
All right, thank you so much.
All right, I have a question for you also. Where did you get the sunflower oil for those that are on with us today?
I bought it at online, E-S-T-Y.
Okay, Esty. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, excellent. You know, because, you know, the best thing about the, is that sesame oil that you have? Or is
I
that,
have sunflower. It's the sunflower oil.
Right, the sunflower. So the sunflower, do you see on there the smoke point? Does it have a smoke point on there? Because usually you can get sometimes as high as 520 degrees on the smoke point.
I don't see a smoke point.
Okay, usually
there's probably one on there though.
Yes, oils will burn at a certain temperature. Some have higher smoke points than others. Well, sunflower and safflower have the highest smoke points. That's why, you know, for those that are, you know, deep frying turkeys, deep frying turkeys, instead of using peanut oil, you can use sunflower oil.
Okay.
Got it?
Yeah, it just says high oil-gelic. That's basically that. 100% mm-hmm. pure cold press, unrefined, organic, extra virgin, high oil-gelic. That's basically
it doesn't give you a temperature on there anywhere? You see a temperature?
I don't see one, but probably if I go back online and look it up, it probably would have something on there.
Yeah, maybe. That's what they use for the hibachi grills. You ever see the hibachi grills? You know, the Japanese hibachi grills? And that's why that doesn't burn. Because if they use regular oil, you wouldn't be able to sit at that table with them cooking in front of you, because it would be burn too fast. So that would be sunflower or safflower. Those are the two that they use.
Sunflower, all right. Yes, okay.
Or safflower. Yeah. All right. Good stuff, Alan. Good stuff. All right. Thank you so much for sharing.
I'm going to copy. I've found out. I'm going to put that in the chat, Dr. Paul, so folks want to make sure I can reach out to it on Etsy, okay?
Okay. All right. We got K51 up there raising your hand. I see you now. I see you now. She got the hand, Bill. She going good like this.
In the chat. About children's allergies, maybe we can get some herbs for Carter.
Okay, so we're gonna go into the chat after this. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Go ahead.
Hello, Dr. Paul.
Yes, and tell us who you are. I just see K51.
I'm Dolores.
Hey, Dolores. How you doing today?
I'm okay. And how are you?
Good. Good.
I wanted to ask you a question. I read on the, I guess it was just a news break that the PAHO says that it should be more people being vaccinated because it won't stop the spread for up to a year if more people don't get vaccinated.
Yeah, that's not true. Not at all. We don't agree with that at all. Yeah, because I mean, they're just trying to get more people to get vaccinated. But you can see what's happening. The COVID-19 slows down because more people's immune systems are naturally getting used to the surroundings. Got it? So viruses live and they die. They have their course, and this 19 is taking its course. So that's why they're saying now, you know, it's taking its course. They're trying to attribute it to a lot of vaccines, but really there's more people still that have not gotten it than have it. So that shows you that it's absolutely the immune system of people in general, just like any cold or flu, it takes its course. So now you never even heard anything else about the flu this year. What happened to the flu?
At all.
Nobody's talking about the flu at all. What happened to the flu? Well, are there any flu numbers? I mean, everything was just boggled into one COVID-19. But now what you're experiencing, this is the question. This is the concern. With now everyone having a build immunity right now to this COVID-19 that's happening, what's happening with this variant called the Delta?
Mm-hmm.
Delta is the problem, because Delta is actually It's not something that we've seen before, and it is 50 to 60% more contagious. So they're looking at that as the way that, you know, they're already talking about boosting, you know, those who had shots getting a booster.
Yes, you got a booster.
We say, hey, we boost every day. We boost right with these herbs, right with these, you know, syrups, all these things that we're doing. We're boosting every day. You're building a system. And remember those number one numbers that come out of their own books, which is the Lancet, the New England Journal of Medicine, the JAMA, all those medical journals. It says specifically that this is less than 1% if you stay healthy, if you're, mm-hmm. if your immune system is on level. Even if you have a pre-existing condition, you're still under that 1%. So why are we doing this? We don't understand why people are still doing it. It's the media. It's the presentation, how they're presenting it to you, that you need it. You got to have it. You don't get it. You know, that's the American way, you know. So be careful. Read up. I would say read up, family. Got it?
Now, yes, that's why I wanted to ask you another question.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
You were talking earlier about, you know, things that you want to do and to just go ahead and try to do them. And it's just that I keep having this vision and I want to put this plan into progress. So, I mean, I'm trying to say, like, when you keep having this vision over and over again, that must mean that you must go ahead on and try to put it in force.
So that means you keep getting a vision, something.
Yes,
you're supposed to do something. Yeah, absolutely. You better move on it. You
know, I'm trying, Dr. Paul. Yes, I'm trying.
Grandmom used to tell me, "Little Paul, when you don't do what the Lord tell you to do, you're gonna do it anyway." Wow. And I ended up doing it anyway. So I would just say, don't frustrate yourself.
Yes, yes.
You know, sometimes the lines in the universe is lining up for a great blessing for you. You got it? But also mm-hmm. the blessing that you bring forth is going to be a blessing for somebody else. You got yes. it? That's yes. what we got to think of. Sometimes we don't think about the small beginnings. And when I was in naturopathy school, I remember Dr. Africa told me something. He said, never discount small beginnings. And I said, well, what do you mean? He says, never discount small beginnings. He says, you have your own centrifugal force, just like a planet, and you rotate. And as you start off with a small rotate, what happens? You start to get bigger, right?
Yes, yes.
And
yes.
as you start to get bigger, you pick up momentum. And as you pick up momentum, you pick up force. And then when you pick up force, then you become a force. Woo!
I heard that. Mm-hmm. I heard that.
Woo, man. Yes, indeed. Oh, man. And you see, now you become a force against other forces. Now you have arrived. You got me? So that's why I say, whatever you're doing, whatever your goal is, whatever you want to do, that's always nagging you. Sometimes you wake up. This is how you know the gift is yours. When you feel that if I'm not doing it, I don't feel satisfied.
Oh, yes.
Like,
I know that's right.
You know,
been there, done that, buddy.
If I'm going to waste my time, I'd rather not be wasting my time here. I'd rather be doing this. Mm-hmm. If you keep pointing back to it, that's your gift. So you better go grab it. Got it? Grab your gift.
Thank you, Dr. Paul.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you. All right, Dolores.
Thank you.
All right. All right. We got Stacy and Mr. Lee. What's going on, y'all?
Hey.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello. Hi.
What's up, family? I'm doing all right. Hey, y'all. I just want to let y'all know. Stacy.
Can we return?
They came through this week and had an assessment. And let me tell you, Mr. Lee, he had me cracking up.
Appreciate the nice
comments. Let's give Mr. Lee, I want everybody on here to give Mr. Lee a hand.
Yes, yes.
Mr. Lee, Stacy's father is 90 years old. He's 90 years old.
Let's
give him a hand. Yes, he is, Big B. He's 90.
I appreciate it.
You don't look look 90 does.
Boy, he don't look no more than six, but don't worry, he don't look no more about 18, 19 years old.
That's mighty nice of you. I appreciate it, Will. I got you guys. I know you're hanging in there. I know that.
Yep. Hey, buddy. That's what's up. You got just keep Dr. rolling.
You ain't got no one.
I know that's right. Right.
I told Mr. Lee and Stacy, I said, you know, I had an aunt that she, you know, when you become 90 years old, you let everybody know. And she sure enough let everybody know. Every time you say her name was Helen. I said, Aunt Helen, how you doing? She said, you know I'm 90, right?
All right. Okay.
You know I'm 90, right? I said, hello. Yes, I know you're 90. Before the conversation starts, you know I'm 90 now. So watch what you're talking about to me.
I appreciate it.
That's right. That's right, Mr. Lee. You can say anything you want to say.
I appreciate your next comment. I hope you're well the rest of the year.
That's right. That's right. All right. So what you got, Stacey? What's happening?
Okay. I just want to tell anybody, if you ever get a chance to go see Dr. Paul, he takes his time. He's very thorough. He's very patient. He's really concerned about you being your best self. And he's an encourager. He has the gift of encouragement. I mean, he's a naturopathic, but he has the gift of encouraging people. And I'm just grateful that we got a chance to go.
Thank you so much. That is very kind words. And I thank you so much. But I tell you, the pleasure is mine. You know, when there's no greater service is to do your gift and give your gift back and to see it help others. That's why I'm saying, I'm sowing this tonight that I hope that someone can hear me, that this may be a Zoom call for you, that this time to get moving on your dream, on your goal, on whatever it
all
is.
All right. Appreciate
you
know, it.
If you have something, if you're not sure about it, pray about it. How about that?
That sounds good.
Absolutely.
Ask for encouragement. Ask for, you know, the Lord to show you where in the direction or bring the people in your life that need to make it happen. I challenge you. It will happen. You got to.
You always give him the praise every night.
That's right.
Every day, morning and night.
So it was.
I do have a question.
Okay.
One question.
My sister has a very, very mild case of lupus. Very mild. She just takes Plaquenil. That's all she does. She goes to see a rheumatologist all the time. But is there any kind of herbs that deal with your autoimmune?
Yes.
System.
Absolutely. Autoimmune. Okay. When we talk about autoimmune, when you talk about lupus, the word lupus comes from wolf. It means wolf. White blood cell. Right. The body moves almost like a wolf, like a scavenging wolf goes through and sort of just like literally eats the body. It's attacking itself. So what's happening with that, when we look at any autoimmune, we know we have to clean the blood. That's where it's coming from.
All right.
You got to clean the blood. You remember old folks we used to say back in the day? You just got tired blood. You just got tired blood. And you got to clean that blood. You got it? So when you're ever in doubt, when things like fibromyalgia, sarcoidosis, lupus, multiple myeloma, you know, things like endometriosis, anything that's autoimmune, and that goes into leukemia also. You have to clean the blood. Sadly, though, people don't even know or understand how that happens. How do you clean the blood? Well, that means that when the blood starts to get thick and gunky, that means it can't send the signals and it loses its energy all throughout the body. So now your body tends to be like a sludge and therefore sends signals, cross signals throughout your body. So that's where the liver gets gunked up. So that means your liver has to be, you know, cleansed because the liver's trying to make it happen, right? So what do we do?
That goes
back to the blood cleansers, So if not to diagnose, treat, cure, prevent any disease, just food for the soul family. One of that I truly love as a blood cleanser would go back to things like the docks, like the burdock.
Burdock.
You know, blood cleanser. Also the Pau D'Arco, PAUD'ARCO, Pau D'Arco. That's the bark from a Brazilian tree. Also, we got to look at things like yellow dock. Yep. Yellow dock. Another one would be red clover. You remember we gave out the list last week, Big B?
Yeah, I wrote them down.
So if you can just read that list was the ultimate list.
Hey guys, remember, okay, it was in the chat.
If you have not
as yet requested the chat from last week, all that information is in the chat.
Yeah, please get the list that we talked about last week. I wrote them down.
Stacy wrote them down.
Yeah, that's it. I think the list had about
40 in them, Dr.
Paul. And guess what? Let me give you the heads up. That's the list for this this coming Delta and black fungus and white fungus.
You start to do these right here.
You better get prepared for this thing, build your immune system so it bounces off of you, doesn't mess with you. Got it? So that's the list. Does anybody have that list right now that they can read it off? You got it? Can you read it off?
One was parsley, milk thistle, burdock root.
Read it a little slowly there.
I'm sorry.
Stacey.
Parsley.
Mm-hmm.
Milk thistle. Burdock root.
Mm-hmm.
Was it guinea hen?
Guinea hen. Mm-hmm.
It is G-U-I-N-E-A, hen. Chaparral.
Chaparral was there too, yes.
Moringa.
Moringa. Thank you.
Al DiArco. That's P-A-U, capital D, apostrophe, capital A-R-C-O.
Amen.
Red onion. Red clover. Mugwort.
W-O-R-T. Right, stop right there. Mugwort is the one that's called also Artemisia. Artemisia is being in, that was in Tanzania. You remember, Big B, we did the story on what's happening in Tanzania right now.
Yes,
They're actually using this, and that is they're saying their cure for the COVID-19. They're calling it. That's what they, and the World Health had to back them up, but people were ordering it like crazy. But here, it's called Mugwort. Mugwort. Got it? Okay, keep going. Keep going.
And it's Thuja, T-H-U-J-A.
Okay, let me stop you on that one. Thuja, just as you're going through them, I'm going to try to give you a little details with each one, okay? Thuja is the evergreen. That's the evergreen, and that's the antiviral. That's a very important one right there. Thuja was used for things like the herpes virus. Any signs of herpes in the herpes virus? That's what that was used for. It actually goes in and literally takes down the virus. It puts and stops its ability to replicate. So those who were having issues with like HIV, herpes, or any form of virus, that's what, and that includes, what was the other one? There was a couple of them, I couldn't remember which one they were, but that is the best one that you can use for viruses. Got it? And that comes in a liquid form, and that's the evergreen trees. You ever see the evergreen trees that like you ever see someone who have rich property, they got property outlines and it's got those like Christmas tree looking trees outline the property? Well, that's the evergreen. That's the thuja. That's the thuja right there. So people were taking Thuja. Thuja.
Thuja.
Yes. Okay. Okay, go ahead, Stacy. Okay.
Golden seal.
Mm-hmm. Golden seal root. The root, not the herb. Root. The root.
We had right.
And is that burdock root as well?
Yeah, you said burdock already. Mm-hmm.
So is it the root or
burdock root? Yeah, burdock root. Yes, that is correct. Oh, always the root. The root is always going to be the strongest.
Okay.
Oh, boy. That's something.
Then it was sheep, sorrel?
Sheep sorrel. Yes, sheep sorrel was used by the Native American Indians. That's the one that they put in the oils of sheep sorrel, and that actually literally eliminated cancer. That one, whew, they had to back up on that one at the research, because when they started doing the research at the institutions, when it came up where it started destroying cancer cells, they said, we're going to shut this study down.
Mm-hmm. See, that's not right. Shut them down.
We got to shut this study down. And they stopped certain people from getting it. And it's a big thing about sheep sorrel. But definitely, sheep sorrel is a cancer fighter. Got it?
Oh, boy. Okay.
Blood cleanser. All of these are blood cleansers. Remember, family, keep in mind, blood cleansers. Go ahead.
That's fine.
Okay, goldenrod.
Goldenrod, yes.
Okay. Blood root.
Mm-hmm. Blood root was the main ingredient in black salve. You remember black salve? Oh, y'all remember black salve, right? Some of y'all remember going to the store for your mama and having getting that black salve, you know, from the store. Came in like look like a shoe can, shoe.
Yeah.
Black. You know, yep, absolutely. A pool, anything. You know what the black salve used to do? They used to put it on any type of growths, like bumps, blisters, boils, you know, and anything growths on the body. You know what it does?
Come on, dude.
We call this one. Let me tell you where this was a shout. This was like herbal surgery. We call it like herbal surgery. You know what it would do? Like, say if you had, if somebody had like some cancer or something in their skin, right? Or a lump or something, it would go in and you would put a little black salve on there. It would literally bore a hole in the top of that area where that, that was. Reach down, grab the cancer, and then start to move it forward out like a ball. And they call that the core. So when it pulls out the core, here's where you got to see God. You got to see God. As it's pulling it out, it's healing.
Yes, sir.
As it's pulling it out.
To
the point where you pull out the core, which is like literally you could see what the cancer looked like, a little ball. And then it starts to seal the hole up as it goes. Well. Woo! You can't see God. You ain't looking, boy. That is me. But see, they took that off the market because people were using it, and they were using it inappropriately and generously, too generously, without proper, direction. And then they ended up banning it. You know, that's what it was. But you could get this at your local store. You should go right to the corner store. At that time, the herbal store was the drug store.
Yeah.
Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. It. I don't know. But anyway,
that was it.
Yep. Absolutely. Yep. So that's where, you know, go ahead with the blacks. That's where the blood root comes from. That's one of those ingredients in there. Go ahead.
Hey, you said black seed bitters, the oil. Is it the oil or just black? Is that a liquid black
seed?
Or?
No, that's the bitters. That's the tonic. Black seed. Yeah, I always recommend the black seed tonic. Because the tonic has more in it, and that means the tonic has more. I use the black seed bitters tonic just like I use this, the old Indian.
Okay.
Just like I use that. I use the tonic.
Okay. Yeah.
The liquid?
It's a liquid. Yep.
Okay.
Liquid.
All right. Okay.
Yep, it's a liquid tonic. Yep.
All right.
Then it's Cape aloes. Is that C-A-P-E or K-A-P-E?
That's C-A-P-E.
Aloes.
Aloes. A-L-O-E-S. Now, the Cape aloes comes from South Africa specifically. They come from South Africa because South Africa, below the equator, that's actually like, it's from the aloes, the same, not aloe vera, not to be confused with aloe vera, but it is in the same family. But Cape aloes is used for moving the digestion. It's one of the bitters. So whenever there's bitters, that's what binds the poison happens in the blood. It happens in the blood and pulls that stuff out of you. Woo!
Awesome. Okay. Dr. Paul, some of the folk are asking if they can get this list. Listen, guys, just submit an email to me, mechavideo@comcast.com. I'm sorry. Yep. Mechavideo@gmail.com. Mechavideo@gmail.com and request
spell it.
Last week. That's M. I'm going to put it in the chat. MECCAVIDEO@gmail.com.
Yes.
And request the program from 6-2. That's from last week. And all of these, everything that's on this list is what we're talking about right now.
That's right. That's right. This is a powerful list, man. We just did this off the top of the head last week. Sure and is. This is so powerful because now here we are coming around again. You got to build up your arsenal. This is the time to build up your arsenal of herbs and things, whether you get it in capsule or in loose teas. Have all it right. on okay. guard so you can start to do these teas so that you can go right in and be a blessing to your family. Okay, Stacey, go ahead.
It's chicory root.
Chicory root. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Cleavers.
Cleavers. Mm-hmm.
Chaney root.
Chaney root. That's correct.
Indian hemp.
Mm-hmm. Indian hemp. Yep. That's right. Oh,
wow.
Mahogany bark.
Mahogany bark. Mm.
Wow.
Garlic, ginseng.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Black root.
Mm-hmm. Black root.
Ginger.
Say that again.
Ginger.
Ginger.
Ginger. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Dandelion.
Yep. Good old dandelion.
Mm-hmm. It's still there. No
growing in out. Everybody's yard. Right
oh, everybody.
Dandelion growing in everybody's yard.
Yeah.
You got a piece of it, that's all.
Strong back.
Strong back.
Oh, nice.
Then sarsaparilla.
Sarsaparilla.
Sarsaparilla. Mm-hmm.
Yellow dock.
Mm-hmm.
Hyssop.
That stuff.
Hyssop. That's the Bible's favorite right there, right? May I purge my body with hyssop. Mm-hmm.
Frankincense.
Frankincense.
Myrrh.
Mm-hmm. Myrrh. Also biblical.
Mm-hmm. Wood root tonic.
Wood root tonic. Stop right there. That is the tonic of the people of the Cameroons, the ones that never went into slavery,
different tribes,
took captive Portuguese, and right? Well, went no, down African. To Jamaica. Yeah.
African.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Usually in places like down in Jamaica where they would never capture slaves, they have a tonic and they use this as a yearly tonic. So it's called wood root tonic and it has a combination of a lot of these blood cleansers in there. So you sometimes can just go get the wood root tonic. If you go to your local store, some of the herbal stores still do carry wood root tonic, especially the Jamaican stores. Okay, if you go there and ask for the wood root tonic, you'll get it there. Okay, go ahead. Mm-hmm.
And then you said sea moss.
Sea moss, absolutely. Yeah, sea moss, you can get, if you can get purple sea moss, that would be even best. Most of the sea moss right now is coming from St. Lucia. You know, most of it's coming from St. Lucia's. But so whatever the case, get sea moss, purple would be better. Okay? A little stronger.
And then you said duck flower?
Duck flower, yes. I was yes, because someone on the show asked me about duck flower. I said, and when that went, I don't know why, when they mentioned it to me, I was thinking duck flower as in flour for like cooking flour. I don't know. it just came to my mind. Then I said, "Oh, you mean the herb? You mean yes, the flower? Oh, okay.
You mean the herb?
Yes, herb or the flower. It's actually another Jamaican herb that is used for cleansing. Yeah, probably it's more my South American. You know, it's used in South America also for blood cleanser. Yes.
Why not?
Okay, and that was it.
All right, I'm going to add one more. OSHA root. OSHA. Right, OSHA, O-S-H-A root, OSHA root. And of course, that list that you got there, that is not to diagnose, treat, cure, prevent any disease, just food for your soul, family. Amen. Right?
That's right.
All right. That's just Amen. Food for the soul. Keep that on your hearts. And, you know, you don't have to get all of them. But it's That's good right. to know that you have
access to the
multiple solutions to a yes. problem. You yes. got it? We've been taught to grab everything. You don't have to grab everything. God said, I got everything. I'm going to give you a little bit of something. All right. Give you something because y'all got different tastes. Yes, you know how y'all are. I don't like that. I like that, though. Everybody has a difference. So find the one that works for you. Got it? Try them. But understand mm-hmm. what they do. The key is to know thyself mm-hmm. is our key for health. But to know the herbs is also to know why you're taking it. Don't just take something because somebody said take it. Know why you're taking it. Got it? All right. Thank you, Stacey. Thank you so much. You were a blessing with us there. Yes, thank you. Big B.
Yeah, man. Yeah. And again, I just want to remind everybody, if you want to get that list and all the things Dr. Paul talked about, just send me an email, and I put it into the chat, to mechavideo@gmail.com, and request the program from the Family Tree from 6/2/2021. Make sure that you get a copy of it. And also, if you also want a copy of tonight's program, I also put that request in as well. We can make sure that once we get finished tonight, Dr. Paul gets me all the information, and we'll probably get it out to you tomorrow, all right? So just kind of mm-hmm. keep that kind of thing in mind.
Right. Yes.
Are those herbs that you just mentioned, are they good for bloodshot eyes?
Bloodshot eyes. Well, usually bloodshot eyes, there can be, we have to determine what's causing the bloodshot eyes. Usually, whenever there's signs of cleansing needed with the liver, that usually the eyes are turning like a yellow. That's actually jaundice. Okay, jaundice. You ever heard of jaundice? That's the bile building up and is backing up in the eye. You ever see anybody with yellow in their eyes?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Toxic liver. That's what that usually means, toxic liver. So if you're cleaning the liver, you clean the brain. You clean the brain, you clean all of the organs in the body. You know how they're talking about they're finding the virus in other parts of the body? And they're saying, well, why is it that we're finding it? They don't understand that all the blood flows through every part of your body every yes. 20 minutes.
Yes.
So that's why they're finding it all over the body. So that's, you know, just keep in mind, COVID-19 is not a lung disease. It is a blood disease. You got it? You got to clean the blood, right? Okay. So hopefully that'll help you. But we would have to look at that person and assess them if that was the problem with why their eyes are bloodshot. You know, usually it's something dealing with the liver, though. Okay. All right. I had some questions here. I saw one question. Should bacopa burn when placed under the tongue?
Yes.
Bacopa is the herb of bacopa. Bacopa is an aquatic. That is one of our sea vegetables. And then when we say aquatic means land and sea. It can grow in both. And it is good for the brain, for memory. Should not burn. Usually it depends on what kind of a version that you have. Usually it's in capsules, and usually when you take it, it's usually for mind, concentration, focus. Bacopa, and that's spelled B-A-C-O-P-A, is used for when you have issues with memory. It also deals with having the ability to recall. Meaning that when your memory is sort of lagging, that helps the neuron activity and increases circulation in the brain. So we give that to a lot of students when they're studying, when they really want to, you know, get that real, you know, strong focus, or you may be studying for a test or going back to school, grab that bacopa, and that helps you to focus and gather your thoughts. But also, this is one thing that I love about bacopa. It has the ability for you to cross hemispheres of the brain from creativity to logic.
Watch out now.
Ooh. Allows you to go from one extreme to the other, which means like if you have a situation or you're, you know, you can bring out that creativity when you need it, but you can be strong and calculating on the other side at the same time. So, yes, Himalayan. I see you, Laverne. Yep, that's a good one. Bacopa right there. I see it. All right. So hopefully that answers that question. Let's see. Were there any other questions down here?
Yeah, I have one, Dr. Paul.
Okay.
In regard to one moving their bowels, Dr. Paul.
Okay.
Okay. Is there an exercise to help relax you to move your bowels? And number two, is there a certain way to, you need to move your stomach muscles while moving your bowels?
Yes. See that women, is that, who had that question? Is that? Okay. Let me see here. I don't know if I'm looking at the same. Say that again. Read that.
Okay. The question, question is, okay. Is there any exercise to help relax you to move your bowels?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
And second, is there a certain way you need to move your stomach muscles while moving your bowels?
Yep, absolutely. We you know what? I do, and the ladies that are probably listening in the women's group or the men's group know that I do a class on how to poop.
Uh-oh, look out now. Look out, how y'all. To poop.
They said, what? I said, today y'all gonna learn how to poop. They said, what? What do you mean, how to poop? We know how to poop. No, y'all don't. So what you do, the whole thing about is to get yourself and your body prepared for moving your bowels. So many people, one of the many concerns that people with constipation have is that they don't give yourself enough time to move your bowels. You're always in a rush, always in a hurry. When you sit down, you only sit down for a few minutes and you jump right back up. You know, there was a time when you went to the bathroom and there used to be magazines in there. Y'all remember that? Mm-hmm. Wow. Y'all ever went to somebody's house and they had stacks of magazines? And man, what y'all doing? Encyclopedias in there? So, I'm sorry. So what's happening is that we don't wait anymore. I remember my grandmother told me, you know, I always got a good grandma. Ethel May always had something good for little Paul. She said, little Paul, you better sit there and wait. And so I had to sit there and wait. So I guess that's where I first became a good thinker, was right on the toilet.
Yes, yes, yes.
So I sat there and they said, little Paul, just wait and then relax. She would always tell me, she says, just act like, just let every muscle go. That's what she used to say.
Yes, yes.
So as I got older, I started to do this, and you know, and then she would, you know, always be conscious of, you know, asking me, you know, did you go boo-boo today? You know, she would say, you boo-boo today? She would always say this to me as I was little, and it became embarrassing when I was with my buddies. She said, hey, little Paul, you go boo-boo today, Grandma, please, please. That's not a conversation for right now. But what she was teaching me was how to stay regular. You got
yes,
it?
Yes.
That's
yes.
what she was teaching me. Even at that young age, she was teaching me. So what do we do? Number one, you got to relax. You want to place your hand on your tummy. Everybody place your hand on your tummy right now. Place your hand on your tummy. And you start with the breathing. So when you're sitting on the toilet, you got to start to breathe. You just got to start to breathe. Take your time and breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth, through pursed lips, where you actually, like you're blowing out of a straw. So remember, we're belly breathers. We're not chest breathers. We're belly breathers.
Yeah, you are. Yeah, that's right.
When you breathe in, stomach comes out, right? And when you breathe out, stomach goes down. One, two, three, breathe in. No chest movement, no chest movement, and blow it out. Mm-hmm. Tummy goes down. See how that goes? So if you do that on, you know, preparing yourself for moving the bowels, you have to send a signal to your body that it's time to move. So what you want to do, set your time. So you remember we say if you eat, you must eliminate, right?
Yes.
Y'all
yes,
remember that, right?
Always,
you
eat, always
you must eliminate, right? So if you eat, you must eliminate. So set a certain time for you to go to the bathroom. Well, you say, well, wait a minute. I don't ever do that. I just go when I got to go. But guess what? You can set the time when you can actually prepare your body and it will move when you want it to move. How about that? So that means when you go in, first you want to start to do is to breathe, and then I want you to start to now massage the stomach. So when you're sitting on the toilet, I want you to start to breathe and you start to massage the belly. Mm-hmm. So that's the sending the signal saying, all right, now it's about that time. Okay, it's about that time. You're sending a signal to the body that it's about the time to move. You got it? So as you do this, I want you to start to now breathe and then relax. And then when you feel like it's about to move, when you feel like you're about to move, see, y'all ain't know y'all was about to learn how to poop on Zoom, did y'all?
Well, it works.
Y'all was about to learn how to poop on Zoom. Say, what did y'all learn tonight? We was just pooping on Zoom, that's all. All right, so here we go. So when you have your stomach like this, just before you're about to move, I want you to do something. I want you to arch your back, arch your back, lock your fingers like this, turn them upside down, and push up like that.
What?
Y'all see that? Y'all watching me? You do like this, arch your back, and push up. Now, when you do this, you arch your back as just before you're about to go to the bathroom, eliminate, guess what? You're opening up the descending side of your colon. If you open up the descending side, which is the left side, everybody touch your left side. Yep. Your other left side. Yep. That one. That one, that side. That left side. As you do this, as you stretch like this, you open it up and you breathe. And guess what? It allows it to drop down and you have almost a double elimination.
Wow.
Did you see? Did you hear that? You get a double elimination just by doing that. So if you practice that, and do like that, and just hands over the head, stretch them up just before you're about to move, arch your back, and I guarantee you're going to get a double elimination because it allows the that's trapped, usually trapped on the left side. That's where the beef eaters are. The beef eaters are right on the other, to the left side. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, the beef side, left side, that's the side that usually starts to, it drops right on down. Got it? That's a little technique. Now, there is one other technique. It's called the Bushman squat. The Bushman squat. Yep.
Well,
y'all know what a Bushman, when he squat down like that, they call it the Bushman squat. But we're going to use a different method of the Bushman squat on the toilet. You just get a small little chair or a little, you ever see the little stools that go in the bathroom? If you ever see anybody with a stool in their bathroom, that's what it's for. That's what it's for. Well, it's not for getting stuff on the top shelf. It's probably for propping the legs up slightly. Got it? Now, there is a, when you put your feet up on the, just slightly up, doesn't have to be high, just slightly up on that piece, and just same thing as you exercise, when you feel like you're about to move, you lean forward with your knees pressing against your belly. As you do this, guess what? Double elimination again. How about
that? There you go.
Double elimination. Got it? That also, you, some people will have the small stairs, like a little step. There is one called the, I think it's called the squatty potty. You ever heard of that? Y'all ever heard of the squatty potty?
Yipper.
They actually sell toilets made like that now.
They got toilets made like that.
Yeah.
Oh, really? That would be a great idea. That's a great idea. But all of those things help you with moving the bowels, all right? So that's what I would say. You gotta get the, you gotta get it moving. So yes, that can help you. All right. Good question. Good question. Anybody have a question on that one? That was good. Can you recommend anything to strengthen the pelvic muscles besides Kegels, so that you don't leak urine before making it to the bathroom?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, so I would say that question right there is a good question. I would recommend someone that has a problem with, you know, if they're leaking urine or they're finding that they're becoming a little incontinent, then definitely we have to look at other things. So assessment would be in order with that, okay? And I think, who's that, Joe? I think Joe asked that.
Yeah.
And, you know, so that would be something that I would look into as an assessment. You'd be for... Be careful, because you know what? A lot of incontinence comes from usually urinary tract infections, so UTIs. Because if you're holding it too long, it weakens the bladder, okay? All right? And let me just take, I'm going to take two more. I'm going to take two more and we got to go. Okay. Two more. I see you, Big B. I see you rolling your finger over there. I see you rolling your. All right. We got.
Can I go? Because it seems like I'm always the last person.
Oh, I don't know. You can't. I didn't even see you in there today. Go ahead, Michelle.
Michelle was hiding. That's what she
mm-hmm. was. She was hiding.
No, because it just popped in my head. I had a couple herbs that I wanted to know what was safe to consume while I'm expecting. So is oat straw, sarsaparilla, if I said it right.
Sarsaparilla.
Sea moss, gel, and elderberry. Are they safe to consume?
Well, remember, your specific situation, you would need an assessment. You know, that would be reckless for someone to say, give you any recommendation while you were pregnant. Got it? So never do that. Always get an assessment to see where your levels are and what your body's asking for, especially when you're bringing somebody in this world. Got it? So many things that are done, I can tell you in general what is used. When women are pregnant, we lose this thing called I think we talked about it. I think last week we talked about the reproductive factors, which are certain herbs that are used specifically for women. One that is for women that are pregnant is that red raspberry. And if there was a recommendation of a specific herb, most naturopathic doctors will actually always recommend a red raspberry with everything that you take, because it sort of like delivers it safely to the body. It's the nurturing herb. It sort of balances. So if there was a need for cleaning the liver or something like that when you are pregnant, then they would use red raspberry to nurture, to bring it to you safely and the baby safely. Got it? Yeah. So, but I would not do anything until I would get recommendation from an herbalist. Are you working with someone right now?
I just got a doula.
Okay, good. So I'm sure they can work with you, but definitely make sure you know what you're taking, okay?
Okay.
And always know what you're taking and if you need it. See, that's the thing. If you need it. You know, it's not it's not the most things, it's the balanced things that you
are.
You got it?
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. I got an assessment with you next month, so
All right. Well, we're going to see you then. All right. We'll see what you are. How far along are you?
About 17 weeks.
17 weeks. All right. We're going to ask for blessings for you. Let's give her a hand, y'all.
Amen. Amen. That's right. That's right.
Blessings.
That's
exactly blessings.
Right. Yes.
Praying for you. All right. Let me grab a couple more. Let me grab Gwen. Gwen?
Okay, so I just have a question about my feet swelling. Mm-hmm. Do you have any recommendations for that?
Yes. Feet swelling, is this ankles or feet or both?
I guess it's both.
Okay, whenever it's usually swelling in the feet and the ankles is definitely lymphatic system. So we're looking at, you know, moving the lymphatic system. Has to be definitely forms of inflammation, but also kidneys. Got it? So you got to get the kidneys moving. That's why we use the one that I recommend, you know, based on, you know, this person's that when they come in that seems to do well in general, just in general, not to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease, just food for the soul, would be the dandelion root. Okay. Dandelion is used as a way of pulling off the water, but also kickstarting the kidneys, cleaning the liver, but also when it pulls the water, because that water has a lot of nutrients in it, puts the potassium back into the leg so that the legs and the feet and the ankles and don't get weak. Okay.
Yes.
So it's a way of keeping and regenerating the foot. Okay.
So with the dandelion, is it as a tea or the capsule or what?
Either one works for you. Mm-hmm. Either one works for you. Yep. Okay. And I would probably try out with the tea first. I would start with the teas. Okay. Yep. Okay. And just try to do it twice a day.
Okay. And do I need to support the potassium with bananas or anything like
that? Well, I think you're going to get a lot of potassium with that red, with the dandelion. There's a lot of potassium in that. A lot of potassium in that. Yep.
Okay.
And awesome. That's something that thing grows all around us, and we don't even know how powerful that thing
is. Yeah, that's true.
That poor dandelion say, I'm trying to do you right, and you cutting me down. Good, not say you.
About 1,000. Cutting it down by 1,000.
Cutting it by 1,000. That's the weed. They call it weed.
Yeah, no, just a weed in the yard. Just get rid of that and weed.
Get rid of them weeds out my yard, you know.
Yeah.
The weed's going to save your life. All right. Let me go to, I got a few more. I got Margaret. Go ahead, Margaret.
Hi, Dr. Paul. Hi, everyone. Thank you for taking my question.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I'll ask the easy one first. I only have two. What do you suggest to help with someone who has sleep apnea?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sleep apnea, definitely the circadian rhythms. I would make sure that they're number one. The circadian rhythms are in balance. You know, sleep patterns have a lot to do with that, and digestive system. Move them off number one. You got to get your water right. Okay, you got to get your water right. That's just sort of like a little checklist. Water first. Make sure they're hydrated properly. Have enough water. The best quality water and the best quantity of water.
There you go. Together.
Got it?
Together.
And then also stay off the dairy products.
Milk crab.
Cow's milk is for calves. Got it? All mm-hmm. dairy products. That includes yogurt, cheese, milk, all of that. Got it? All that stuff has to go. Fermentation. Stay off fermented foods. You know, the things like the kombucha, the kimchi, you know, the sodas, you know, all of those foods that cause acid, you know, carbonated beverages, you know, it's usually those things that are causing inflammation and causing issues that, you know, that mess up the sleep patterns. And then we got other things going on, especially I'm going to focus on that dairy. You got to really watch the dairy. Okay. So that's just a few. Mm-hmm.
Great. Thank you. And my second question, I'm asking this for someone else because I couldn't think of anything. It's regards to when we rinse off our vegetables and fruits in baking soda to make sure we're getting all the pesticides and chemicals, is there any product that we can test our vegetable or fruit afterwards to make sure we're getting everything off of it that we should?
Usually when you're using, remember the thing that we know washes off pesticides, chemicals, bacteria, virus, fungus, is when something is now alkalized. So the highest alkalinity would be baking soda. So remember, these things cannot live in an all alkaline state. So that's why when they did the test, after they looked at the test, boom, they showed that it was no longer bacteria on it. Virus kills it all. Is there a test? Not really a test that I can think of. Other than, you know, the water test that we use, we can use hydrogen drops and things like to see if water has a certain pH or something like that. Really, you're just trying to make sure that it's, you know, if it's an apple or a vegetable or something, that you clean it properly. It's the best way you can do it. Okay. And it usually has to be done scientifically, you know, in order to see if the pesticide is still there. But we know that the universal principles are in order, that if alkaline is present, then it destroys bacteria, virus, fungus, sepsis, parasites, and things like that. Okay?
Great. All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Paul.
Okay. All right. I have over there Jewel. Jewel?
And Lydia.
Yes, Jewel. How are you?
Good, thanks. How are you, Dr. Paul?
All right.
Good evening, everybody. I'm finally able to get ask my questions. I have two questions, one for someone else. What would you suggest for someone who's on dialysis three times a week?
An assessment, number one.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Assessment. That's too complicated to go into because the issues with dialysis has everything to do with food choices and diet. The person has to be put on a understanding of what they're eating. They're eating the wrong foods. They're eating too much concentration because even if you give them an herb, they're going to go back and they're going to do the same thing they were doing. So they got to know how to get their water. They got to know how to eat. They got to stay away from certain foods, top 10 toxic foods. So they would need an assessment.
An assessment. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My next concern is what should be done about irregular heart rhythm?
Irregular heart rhythms happen usually because the misfires. Usually it's a malnutrition issue. Usually that's an arrhythmia issue. We detect that a lot with the RM3A. The RM3A detects all of those things with the heart rhythms and, you know, flutters. They call them flutters sometimes. Mm-hmm. And usually they're misfires. That's like a car missing a spark plug. Mm-hmm. Or sometimes you may be walking and you feel like your heart goes like that, or it flutters. That's actually just the misfire. So usually electrolytes are the things that we focus on. Electrolytes are not the electrolytes they talk about, because they sometimes talk about electrolytes as salts. We're talking about the minerals. So we would use things like combinations, not to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease, just food for the soul, right? One would be hawthorn berries. And the other one would be CoQ10. Coenzyme 10. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now, there is also another one called, as a tea to help that, it was called Cinchona. Cinchona. C-I-N-C-H-O-N-A. Cinchona. Okay. Cinchona is where the quinine comes from. Y'all know the you remember the quinine?
Malaria.
Yeah, malaria. That's right. Mm-hmm. Hydroxychloroquine, you know, the one that Trump is taking all that? Guess where it comes from? The quinine comes from the cinchona tree, which is the bark, which is a bark from South America. How about that? So that cinchona is actually used also. It was used for arrhythmia issues. Where heart rhythm and flutters and all those things, because it's replacing the rhythm of the heart. So those are the three that we work with: cinchona, hawthorn berries, CoQ10.
All right. And lastly, how long should you do the oil pulling? How many seconds or minutes? I just bought a bottle of that same unrefined sesame oil that the other lady was just showing. And I wanted to start oil pulling, but I thought they said 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm. You can do it as long as you want to. I got folks pulling for 45 minutes to an hour. Believe it or not, I don't know how they do it. But there's people pulling that long. They really are. You have to build up a resistance to use it, to do it. So when you do it, the more you do it, the better you get. And after a while, you start to see the results. People get motivated by the results. They say, wow, my teeth sure are clean. I think I'm going to go another 15 minutes.
Okay.
I'm going to go another 15 minutes. All right. Last two. Thank you, Dr. Paul. Okay, thank you. I got Wendy and Lydia. Those are the last two for tonight, okay?
Which Lydia?
Lydia C. Okay. H. All right, I got you.
All right, Dr. Paul.
Good. Yes, Wendy.
And Mr. Bill, everybody, good evening.
Hey, good evening.
I was laughing because you were talking about when you get parents and grandparents that are in their 90s. My mother is 91. And this is the reason why I'm on the line tonight.
Okay.
She's been having, she decided to go and get this, get these vaccine shots. She has developed a lot of fluid in her ankles. Which we know has part to do with her salt intake. We've been there before. I had to take her to the emergency room, and I believe she had COVID before they decided to let us know what was going on, because all the symptoms she had back here the first part of January last year. So her body has started, her ankles have started developing fluid. So the doctor said, you know, that to be mindful of her salt intake. What she does not like to do is drink water. So my question is, what type of flavor water is it that I can get for her? If she's hesitant about the lemon water and the lime, but is there another type of water that I can give her that has some type of flavor to it? I know I used to drink the sparkling ice water, but I know there's some limitations to that too, since you told us.
Yeah, no carbon. Yeah, no carbonated beverages. Yeah, she don't want any flavored waters either because they have a lot of salt and sugar in them, you know, okay. Which is refined sugar, refined salt. So you have to find her taste. You know, usually when the swelling of the ankles is having everything to do with the kidneys, that's usually right. What's happening. Right, the kidneys. So what you're trying to do is you can get her something like, you can use peppermint, spearmint, you know, you can use light teas, things like that. Light peppermint, spearmint can give it a little taste and flavor to it to help it. But you got to try to, she's got to try to get past that flavor thing. I think her health is more important than taste right now. That she has to start to go and, you know, I know when she's 91, she's like, I do what I want to do. So I know, I know what she's saying already. I already know the conversation. Say, I want this and I want that. Okay, all right, I hear you. Yes. You know, so I understand. So that's why I said add a little peppermint sometimes. You get some raw peppermint, okay? You can add it to the water. That's good. Spearmint also goes good with the water, okay? A little hibiscus. You can use a little hibiscus or rose hips. That's also something. You can steep them, you know, as little teas, and that can help the flavoring. You're trying to add to the red, you know, the flavoring of it. It's things that give it flavor that she can taste. She doesn't like lemon or lime. What is it that she doesn't like? Lemon and lime.
She'll drink it, but she won't be faithful in drinking. She'll drink maybe about a 16.
Okay, you went mute on us. You went mute on us.
She'll drink the water from out of the faucet. She
not out the faucet. Mm-mm. Just do the best you can. Usually when you try to do that, you know, introduce her to the teas, you know, like, you know, do a combination. You know what I could do? What I would recommend? This is a good one for you. Get like a dandelion tea, put a little mint in it. Okay. Put a little mint in the dandelion tea. Okay. And sometimes you can even add a little lemon or lime to that. That's a combination tea. That's going to give a little bit of excitement to the tea itself, but at the same time, it'll help the kidneys. Got it?
Okay.
Yep. Give it a little thing. Give it a little flavor to it. All right.
And I think I got one. Let me see.
You got one more question? Because we got to get ready to go. Okay.
Okay. Hold on. As a matter of fact, I can wait because I do understand somebody else is on wait, and I can pass that on to somebody else.
Okay.
That question after later.
Okay. Okay, yeah. Wendy. Thank you. All right. Lydia?
Yes, Dr. Paul.
Last but not least. All right.
Always. Lydia C, so we know who we're talking about. The question, you said something about the COVID is not a lung disease, but is a blood condition. Okay. When you said that a couple of Zooms ago, I thought about it. I said, well, if that's the case, why we have to walk around with the mask on? Because there are other blood diseases going on and we're not walking around with a mask on or all these other things.
Right, because it starts at the blood. That's the source of it all. It affects the lungs, but it's a blood disorder. You understand? So it affects the lungs. That's what it causes fibrosis in the lungs.
Okay.
The fibrosis is when it gets hard and it starts to cool the lungs. So it affects the lungs. But okay. The source of the problem is the blood. You got to clean the blood.
Okay. Got it?
So that's why we're wearing masks, because it affects the lungs. But ultimately, you got to clean the blood.
Okay. Right. And the question they're asking, have you had your vaccination? I said, oh, yes, we do it every day. That's the question. I just said we do it daily. And they look at me.
See, this is where y'all got to stop. Y'all got to stop entertaining this stuff.
No, what I'm saying,
when somebody says that, you say, yeah, I had my herbal vaccination.
I did. That's what I'm saying. I started doing
it
daily.
You know, I take my herbal shot every day. That's right.
And okay, if they start doing those What are the papers that we're going to give them? I know you talked about that earlier when they said they still have to show vaccination papers.
Well, remember, you just declare your position. You have the option to declare your position. The position that you declare is that, you know, if you have a strong, if you have a strong religious conviction, you're exempt. You're exempt. Yeah, okay. Basically, that's what all the universities do. Any university, your job, everywhere you go, you have to declare your position. You declare your position by telling them that I am, you know, I have a strong religious conviction. You know, God said, put me first. He said, put me first. You got me? So you got to put him first. And that really does mean put me first. So you put him first and say, hey, I have a strong religious conviction. If you go to church, you got to be doing it. You got a strong religious conviction. You go to church. Is your church doing it? Hey, I don't know. But
yeah,
I'm going to
say. Yeah, my church is doing it. Yeah, they do it. So I'm the minority.
you got to stay strong in the spirit that you got to trust God. You going to trust God? You going to trust God, right?
Absolutely.
Trust me. He said, trust me.
No problem. That's
trust me, you know, and but we have ye of little faith.
Amen.
And, you know, he said these last days would happen, and he had all this in the Revelation.
He knew it was coming before it got there.
It was coming before he got here. So
that's right.
All right, we gotta go, y'all.
One more.
Get off my phone. I'm just kidding, buddy.
You talked about the cat. You talked about the tapping, and I remember that, and because my knee was swollen, and I started tapping, and the next day I got up, and I saw it went down. Boy, the next time, I think I was punching it. It was going down so fast. I said, it's
done. Oh, that's right. Tap it on out.
Tap that boy out.
That's right. Tap it on out, y'all. All right. All right. Maybe we should tap it out before we leave.
I know. That's right, buddy. Tap it on out.
Leave. All right.
Oh, boy.
All right. Big B.
Thank you,
family. I want to appreciate everyone. And we're going to say Big B, close us out as we end off this family tree tonight.
Yeah. Boy, look, I should tap. We just tap it all the way on. Just tap. That's what it's all about, Dr. Paul. Listen, guys, first of all, we just want to thank you for your continued support of the family tree. And as you continue to do that, you see we get this stuff out to you, invite everybody. And of course, as you do that, we want to make sure that you send your donations to the, and using Dr. Paul's Cash App, and that's the $ capital DR, capital PAUL, capital HOP. And you know what? We make sure we get all this stuff back out to you as soon as Dr. Paul gets the link out to me. So I have to beat him up, make sure he gets it to me
beautiful line.
Okay, that way makes it happen. So listen, it works. And we love you guys. And all week, stop Lily from calling us on the phone 10 minutes before we're supposed to go to the bathroom. We love you guys, man.
All right. Hey, family, it has been a pleasure. Yeah. Give yourselves a hand.
Thank you, Dr. Paul.
Yeah, that's what it's all about.
Did you learn anything tonight, y'all?
Make sure you send all your requests to MechaVideo@gmail.com for tonight's chat and for the one from last week if you want that list.
That's right. And hey, the only one thing that I charge you with tonight, and that is charge you with the truth, and that's that you got to go tell somebody. How about that?
Right.
So whatever you're doing, you know, be encouraged, because remember, if you're breathing,
you got a shot.
All right. God bless y'all.
Yes.
God bless you. Thank you.
God bless you.
God bless.
Thank you.
Good night, everybody.
God bless y'all. Tap it out. Let me see you tap it out. All right, or left hand. Get a right hand. Flip it over. Yeah, there you go.
Well, hallelujah.
Clap your hands. All right, good. Tap your head. Anybody home?
Go.
Bring it down. Right, bring it down to the head. Good. Tap the temples. Good. Come on down. Right to the jaw. Good. Tap. Come on down to the chest right here. K27. That's the kidneys right here. K27. This is kidneys. Good, good. That's right in the middle of the chest. That's the thymus. Good, good. Yeah, that's right. Good, good, good. Come on to the ribs. Come on to the ribs. Left and the right. Left and the right. Left and the right. Left and the right. Right side is what? Right side is what? Right side is what? Right side is what? Right. Liver. 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 Gallbladder. 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 What's on the left? What's on the left? What's on the left?
Liver.
What's on the left? What's on the left?
What's on the left?
Pancreas.
Pancreas.
Pancreas. And what? Pancreas and what? No. Pancreas and... Pancreas and no pancreas and pancreas and spleens, 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 spleens. Got it, got it. All right, good, good. All right, last thing, tap yourself on the arm, underarm. Get that lymphatic system moving.
Give it up. Give it up.
Get the other one side. We doing one side, doing the other side.
Give it up.
All right, stay in rhythm now. Stay in rhythm now. Stay in rhythm. Good, 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 good. All right, take a deep breath. Blow it out. Deep breathe in. Blow it out. Good. All right. All right. Now you take your hands. I want you to rub them together like this. Rub them real tight. Rub them real tight. Yeah. Fast. Feel the heat. Feel the heat. Feel the heat. All right. Woo. Then you take them apart and go slap. Woo. Slap.
Wow.
Slap. Knock my arm.
Yeah, broke your microphone.
Broke my microphone. Now, when you take your hands, I want you to take your hands and put them together like this.
Yeah.
And roll the top one, keep the bottom one still. Do you feel something?
Hey.
You might feel like a little ball right in the middle. You feel it?
Yeah.
So, come on, one more time. One more time. Put them together. Bring them together. Fast.
Kick it out.
Build some heat. Build some heat. And then I want you to clap them. Clap. 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 All right, now take your hand, top one, bottom, and just roll the top one over the bottom. You feel it? Feel it? You should start feeling like a little ball. That's your energy.
That's it.
That's your energy right there. How about that? Now you take that energy one more time.
One more
time. This time we're going to do something different.
Different.
Take that good energy. Clap.
It's moving.
Clap.
It's moving.
Yeah, it's moving. And I want you to wipe it all the way down. It's called an energy bath.
Way.
Give yourself an energy bath. There you go. Give your energy bath.
Give it up.
All right, man, y'all done pooped tonight. Y'all done took a bath tonight.
Hallelujah.
All right, God bless. Thank you, Big B. Yes, I appreciate it. Let's give Big B a hand. Give Big Bill a hand.
Thank you, my brother.
Appreciate you for
hosting.
Happy
belated birthday, Bill.
Yes. That's right. Bill got a birthday. Happy birthday to Bill. Hey. That's right, Big B.
Happy birthday.
He tried to sneak it in on us last week. He's 27. All right. Yes, he is.
79, guys. Right. How about that?
79. 79 young. That's right. So God bless y'all. May God keep y'all is my prayer. We'll see you next week on the Family Tree.